Greetings, it's Eric Bakker from New Zealand. Thanks for checking out my video. It's a wet, rainy day today, so a good day to do some videos. I've got a question here from a subscriber, Mr. Ahmed Atia. I think it's a Mr. because of the thumbnail. It looks like a man there playing cricket by the looks of it, so I would say it's Mr. Atia. Mr. Atia says, greetings, Dr. Eric. Diet, herbal treatments and probiotics have helped manage my symptoms. However, I have not been successfully able to fully recover. Recently, my dentist detected 4 cavities in my teeth. Is there a possible connection between oral health and digestive health? After receiving treatment to correct oral health, is there a specific protocol that one should follow in order to fully detox the body from that infection? Thanks in advance, Dr. Eric. Mr. Atia, thanks for the question. So now I'm going to respond to your question. I thought it might be a good one to actually answer this question for subscribers and for other people who may be interested to know about oral health. So I believe oral health is critical for overall health. It is amazing how many people I see with very poor health that have got very poor oral health. It's unfortunate that today that really good oral health and work on the mouth costs a lot of money. So many people, unfortunately, on lower incomes have got poor dental health, resulting in very poor general health. We see that quite a lot. So cavities are often linked with a bacteria called Streptococcus mutans. So if you want to stop getting cavities, the first thing that you want to really do is to eat a different kind of a diet. So my question to you is, if the dentist has detected 4 cavities, why did the dentist detect 4 cavities? Why don't you regularly get a checkup at least every 6 or 12 months, just get the dentist to have a quick look around the mouth to make sure that he or she can fix these things up before they become a big problem. So particularly in dentistry, preventative medicine in dentistry is very big. If you get small problems fixed now, it's going to save you a lot of money and pain and problems down the track. So my question now is, what kind of foods would you be eating? So for anybody to have 4 cavities, you obviously want to keep away from refined foods like breads and soda drinks and candy and ice cream and donuts and cookies and chocolate and candy and all that kind of crappy food. So be sure to be careful eating any of these kind of foods, to take them all out of your diet if you can. They're all usually high in calories and low in nutritional value. They serve nothing really to do for your overall general health. There was a guy a long time ago, Dr. Weston Price, a famous dentist who traveled the world and studied different cultures and looked at different indigenous peoples and their oral health. And for example, when he came to New Zealand a long time ago, I think it was in the 1930s, he found that the Maori population here had some of the best teeth he'd ever seen on Earth. They had roughly 1 to 2 cavities per 1,000 skulls that he examined. And now, today, you were not going to find that with Maori people. A lot of Maori children now, like Aborigine children and American Indian children, and these populations got very poor oral health. And it's due to the introduction of things like soda drinks and ice cream into their diet and white bread, which is destroying their mouths. So the point I'm making is, if you eat like a traditional diet, high in fish and vegetables, and you avoid all processed and westernized food, you're not going to get cavities. You're going to have a much better oral health. And generally, those people had a much better digestive health too. Because good food in here means also better, you know, digestive health, because you're going to be absorbing higher quality nutrition. You're going to get more nutrients from that food. You're going to get more energy and more general health. So poor oral health like cavities tell me that there was something in that food that caused those cavities. So that can reflect in poor digestive health. It also tells me that you've got the wrong kind of bacteria in the mouth. And that can affect your immune system quite a lot. So getting rid of the bad bacteria in your mouth will mean that you're going to get a better balance of good bacteria in the mouth, just like you can in the digestive system. Many people who've got gut problems have got too many bad bacteria and fungi in there and not enough good ones. All the good ones outweigh the bad ones. The same in the mouth. We've also got bacteria in the mouth that are good, we've got bacteria in the mouth that are bad, and we've got bacteria in the mouth that are imbalanced. So we want to get the ecosystem back in the mouth again. We want, you know, the correct ecosystem. We want to get a very good balance of good bacteria in there and bad, because you can't always get rid of the bad. So how do we do that? We do that primarily with diet. We do that by selecting the right kind of foods, by eating spinach, by eating, green leafy vegetables, collards and broccoli and cauliflower and Brussels sprouts. We do that by eating good kinds of fruits, raspberries and blueberries and strawberries, for example, papaya. These are all very healthy foods for the mouth. I think there are many videos I've put on this channel that you can look at regarding selecting the right kind of foods for your diet. So I'd like you to go back and look at those foods on, for example, the top five foods for fighting candida, for example. There are many different videos you can see. There's over 900 on this channel. So eating the MEVI diet is a good start for you. Meat, eggs, vegetables, and yogurt. So remember, there's a big link between oral health and digestive health. People with poor oral health also, in my opinion, don't chew properly and they don't brush their teeth properly. They don't look after their teeth properly. They don't rinse their mouth properly. They don't get rid of the food residues between the teeth. So then it becomes a breeding ground for these bacteria. And of course, swallowing will bring these bacteria into the stomach, which can bypass and go into the small bowel and create small intestinal bacterial problems. The other question to you is, have you had antibiotic therapy? Because, that may have also caused problems orally and in the gut. Many people don't realize it, but antibiotics can also affect oral health, not just health in the small bowel, but also health in the mouth. So that's something I recently discovered through some research I did for a few patients that had very poor dental health that were taking endless rounds of antibiotics. Tetracycline, for example, is an antibiotic that can destroy enamel on the teeth, but it can also kill a lot of bacteria in the mouth. And that can allow bad bacteria and fungi to come up in the mouth. The tongue goes wide, gum disease, all these kind of problems. So antibiotics are not a good medicine to take for any kind of condition, in my opinion. After receiving a treatment to correct oral health, is there a specific protocol one should follow in order to fully detox the body? Check out some of my videos I've done on detoxification. There's no specific protocol I recommend in this situation because I don't know more about you, but suffice to say, I would like you to read my book, Candida Crusher, and have a look at the section I've written in there on detoxification. Also, if you just by start eating the right kind of foods and improve oral hygiene, that's one big step in the right direction for you because that's going to start your body from, being bad, coming to right again. So if you haven't fully recovered, you need to check out your diet. You need to make sure you're eating the right kind of food. Make sure your oral health is good. And just follow some of the instructions in my videos because I'm sure you'll find plenty there to look at. There's over 900 videos, as I said. So I hope that answers some of your questions, Mr. Atia. I'm pretty sure that you should be able to pick up your health quite a lot by following some of these suggestions. Thanks for the question. Don't forget to click on the link in the description box for your free Candida report. Thank you.